Hello. Today we're going to install the TrueNAS SCALE network attached storage software as a virtual machine on our RGNet's RXG. The first step is to click Services and Virtualization. And if you have not already created the virtualization host, you can do so by clicking Create New. And I've done so by selecting the defaults here. Once you've downloaded your TrueNAS SCALE install ISO image, you can click Disk Images by your virtualization host and click Create New. Here you can upload the ISO, which I've already done. Next, click Create New above the virtual machine scaffold, and we'll give our virtual machine a name and select UEFI by the bootloader. Give it the resources that it needs. Give the Ethernet interface a name, and I'll select IGB3 under Virtual Switch because that is the LAN interface of my RXG. We'll give our boot drive a name, and I'll make mine 10 gigabytes. Now we can click Create, and we'll wait for the yellow icon to turn red and say Stopped under State. Now we're ready to install. We'll click the Install button, and we'll select the TrueNAS SCALE ISO that we uploaded earlier. And click Install. Now if we switch over to a root console on our RXG, we can type VM console and the name that we gave our VM, and we'll wait for the VM to boot. Once booted, we can select menu option 1 for Install and Upgrade. We'll select the 10 gig disk that we created, click Yes to proceed, and we'll set an administrative password. Now we'll wait for the system to be installed. Once the install is complete, we can click OK, and I'm going to shut down the system. Once you see power down, to detach from the virtual machine console, you can hit Enter, tilde, and Control D in that order, and that will put you back at the RXG root console. The reason I shut the machine down is I have an 8 TB drive that I want to pass through to the TrueNAS server, so I need to make a configuration change. The configuration for the virtual machine is in zroot, in bhyve, B-H-Y-V-E, and the name of the virtual machine. And in this directory, there is a configuration file. We're going to edit that file. You can see disk 0 is already in the configuration file. That's the 10 gig boot drive that we've created. But I'm going to add some configuration parameters to pass through the raw disk for the other drive that I have installed. And once we've made those changes, we can write the file and type VM start in the name of the VM. And we'll attach back to the console. Now we'll wait for the VM to boot up. Once the VM is booted, we'll select menu option 1 to configure the network parameters, and we'll select the only Ethernet interface, IPv4 DHCP, no, and under aliases, we will set the IP address that we want the VM to have, insider notation. We'll click Save, A to apply, and P to make them persistent, and Q back to the main menu. Now we'll go into menu option 2 to configure the network settings and set the IPv4 gateway and the name server. And we'll click Save. Now you may just browse to the IP address here to reach your TrueNAS server, but I set up a virtual host to access mine. So I'll log in with the credentials that I set earlier, and we'll go to Storage and Create Pool. And here you see the drive that we are passing through, which is 7.28 terabytes. Now I only have one drive attached. You may have many more if you want to use a stripe or a span. But for demonstration purposes, we'll add this to the VDEV. We'll give the pool a name, and we'll force the creation. And once the drive is initialized, we will see that we have 7.14 tibibytes available on the pool. Thank you very much for watching.